Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's take a look at predictive typing in iOS 8. So we can see predictive text whenever we bring up the keyboard in iOS 8, whether it's on the iPhone or the iPad. Here I am on the iPhone and I'm in the Notes app. And you see it right away. I haven't even typed anything. And right above the keyboard you see I, the, and I'm. And it puts these up there because it feels that these are the most likely things for me to want to type here at the beginning of typing a document with nothing else there. So let's start typing and see what happens to those three buttons there. Now notice it kept changing depending on what I was typing and trying to predict what the word was I was using. And you can see here on the middle of typing the word jumps, and the middle button there is the word jumps. So if I want to just skip having to type the M, P, and S, I can tap jumps and it finishes the word and puts a space after it. Let me try to finish the line using predictive text as much as possible. So there I was able to do it with less keystrokes than if I had just typed out every letter. But predictive text actually does more than just try to predict the word based on the context of what you're typing. It'll actually take a larger context. For instance, here I am in my Messages app and I'm going to get a text message here from someone and it'll appear there in a second, and you can see right away it figures out that a question is being asked. And it throws up yes and no as the main two things I might want to say in response to that. But it's not just simple yes or no. For instance, if you get a question like this, you can see it figures out that there are two options here in that sentence. So it's actually figuring out the sentence and it's giving me the option of responding quickly with pizza, tacos, or even a not sure. And here's another one with three different options. And you can see it figures that out as well. Now, predictive text is actually paying attention to what you're typing and coming up with suggestions based on context. So for instance, say I want to type the color purple. So I will start typing P-U-R and you notice it still doesn't figure out what I want, but the fourth letter it gets it. But instead, if I were to be typing a sentence, you can see it gets purple right away from the first letter because of the context, probably the word color right there. It even puts pink as another suggestion. So pay attention to what it's doing and don't assume that because, say, it doesn't come up with the word when you type the first letter or two one time that it won't another time, because it may be because of the context that it figures out what the word is, not so much because of how many letters that you've typed. Now you do have the option to turn on and off predictive typing. You can do that. You can see the key at the bottom, it's a little smiley face that allows you to change keyboards. If I tap that, normally it goes to another keyboard. And I'll go back to this one. And if I, instead of tapping it, if I tap and hold, you can see it comes up with what would be a list of keyboards. But the very first option there is a switch to turn on and off predictive typing.